Hi everyone, this is Anna Wheaton from Nudge Nudge Ink Ink, and I'm popping on to show you a technique today called the bubble technique. I must say I found this when I was looking for a sample of a particular stamp set and saw a video by an American demonstrator called Melissa Faust, who demonstrated the technique, and this is what we made at our class. A team meeting. Everyone loved it. And I just wanted to play around with it a bit more and then also make a video with another version. So what you need for these are your re-inkers. And then you need a cup with some water in it, and you need to add some detergent to your water. So I've done this already with my samples. So I just added a drop of detergent in there. And so I've got about half a cup of water. If you fill it up, you'll make a real mess. And I have just chosen four bright colors. I've got Mango Melody. I have Flirty Flamingo. Oops, undoing that a bit prematurely. Granny Apple Green and Gorgeous Grape. That one's a bit loose too. And then you need some straws. So we've got our laws in place now for our straws, where we have paper straws. So I'm getting into making this before my straws get too soggy. But the good thing is that I can just throw those in for recycling and not have plastic straws everywhere. Now, there is also in here some drops of the ink. But what I need to do is add more, because as Melissa showed in her video, it doesn't really work with just colored water. It's the ink interacting with the bubbles. I have two pieces of cardstock here. One is shimmer white and one is our watercolor paper, just to show you the difference. So imagine that's water, plain water. I've added a little bit of detergent in it, and then I get my straw and I'm going to blow some bubbles. So you want to get those so that they're big out the top of the cup, and then that's when you add your ink. It'll pop some of them, but see how the ink goes around the edges of the bubbles. And it's quite strong. So if I then tap my paper on it, it's going to pick up the ink in the form of bubbles. That's the watercolor paper. And this is the shimmer white. I'm just going to add some ink here. So see how you can see the edges there. Okay, so that's one color. Do have things like paper towels ready, because it is a bit messy. This is now my Flirty Flamingo. So again, I want to do my bubble blowing first. Add a little bit of ink, which gathers on the edges of those bubbles, and then tap this on. So you can see, getting a little bit of a subtle bubbly pattern there. I will show you too, just with one color. Okay, so see how that's coming together. Next one is Granny Apple Green. You can see I have coordinated my cups fairly well with the colors. Bubble that up. And then go for the dippy in the green. See how that's coming together. Now, because it's bubbles and just the edge of the water, or the edge of the bubbles, you'll find that it dries pretty quickly. It's not like you're dipping it in the water. Then the last one is Gorgeous Grape. That's the sound of my lid hitting the... Okay. So there you go. Hi. Two backgrounds there with the colours. Put those aside, and I'm just going to show you one color. This was the original color that we used. This is Starry Sky, and I'm just going to add this to a stitch rectangle that is in Shimmer White. Again, you've got the ink clinging to the edges and the joins of the bubbles. And you'll find as you go on, if it starts getting too pale, that's when you want to add some ink. Yeah, need a bit more there. And there you have it. So it's one of those things where if you're going to make one, you may as well make a few because you're going to make a mess. Right, I'll show you how these have ended up. So the multicolored one is here. So there I have, what I actually did was I colored this and then I chose my four colours for the background from these inks. So we've got Flirty Flamingo, Granny Apple Green, Gorgeous Grape, and Mango Melody. And they are in the background there. Then, as I showed you before, this is the one that I cased from Melissa using the, I can't remember the name of this, swimsuit one. But using that idea and that layout, I made this one. So there's our hippos. So this has got a few celebration items. One is the hippo stamp set, which is free with a $90 order. Cut out using the hippo dies, which includes this cute little boat and the goggles and the snorkel. The dies are free with a $180 order. And then this gingham embossing folder is an extra freebie throughout August with, I think it's a $90 order, I'm pretty sure that's right. With a $90 order, you can get that embossing folder free. So there you have Hippo out on the water with cloud punched with the cloud punch, and I actually wink of Stellard over that too to give it that glitter. So there you have it, a really cool technique to create some fun backgrounds, and thanks to Melissa Faust for the instructions in the first place. If you like my videos, please click hit the thumbs up button, and if you want to subscribe, that'd be fantastic. Thank you. Bye.